So this is why I enjoy doing tech. As you can see from the title, it's always very interesting, it's always evolving and has something positive to offer. And in this video, it's about to show that where the traditional house systems tend to be slow or tend to slack, we can sometimes better use technology to cater for evolving needs when it comes to health and more important matters. Let's discuss that. It seems interesting. Welcome to Half Man Up Tech. If it's your first time watching, I'm your host Ben, of course, and in this video we are going to be analyzing some experiments or some studies that were carried out not by Apple or by Fitbit or by Garmin or by any other tech company that you might think of. These are independent studies that we are going to be analyzing in this video. So we have two private institutions that carried out independent studies in a bid to see how the Apple Watch or smartwatches work when it comes to health in general. We have Mount Sinai Health Systems and Stanford University. For the purposes of this video, we're just going to focus in more details towards the Stanford University experiment. So they took about 5,300 people and analyzed their physiological data and activity data from, you guessed it, a smartwatch. And from these 5,300 people, 32 of them had a positive COVID-19 test. So they knew it before commencing this study, so that of course they take precautions. And after some time or after some tests, they were able to see a pattern towards the people that had the positive COVID-19 test. 81% had changes or alterations in their physiological and activity data. And what we mean by physiological and activity data, we actually mean like information that is like the heart rate and also step to heart rate ratio and also your heart rate reading when you are resting or sleeping. So all this information were studied in great depth towards all 5,300 participants. And as you can see from the people that had a positive COVID-19 test, 26 of them had changes. And what's even more interesting or intriguing from this case study or experiment is that some of the changes that the people who had the positive COVID-19 test showed were being seen prior from this experiment commencing. So in some cases, they were able to detect some of these changes 9 days before some other traditional systems could detect this. Now, I don't know about you, but if you've ever gone for a COVID-19 test, you know the types of methods they use. They use your nasal fluid, sometimes they use your saliva, sometimes they use your blood. So if you didn't skip your science classes, you know that body fluids have to do with nucleic acids. And sometimes nucleic-based diagnosis or test may require several days post exposure for a positive detection. So that's why you find that sometimes when you go for a COVID-19 test, you might not, you know, come out positive, although you feel weird. And after a few days, you find out that you do have it. And also sometimes you find that the results do not come out right there and there. So they tend to be slow when it comes to detection and so on. And there's a lot you can actually do with the Apple Watch. And this is like one example of many. So with just this device, I can measure my blood oxygen, the amount of oxygen that my blood has, and also I can measure my VO2 max when I'm doing a workout, which is the maximum volume of oxygen that my body is using as I'm working out. And if it detects that my VO2 max is low, it will alert me so that I avoid the dangers that might be associated with that. And also with this device, atrial fibrillation is something that I can measure. I can measure my ECG and heart rate. And those are some of the many things that tech has enabled. And in this case, when it comes to the Apple Watch, it's proving to be one of the best devices or best health devices, if we're to put it. There's a lot we can cater for with tech, and if we integrate it into the health systems and also just, you know, use it to its full potential. You know, don't just buy an Apple Watch to look at your time or just because it looks cool or just for the Apple ecosystem. This is more of a health device than just a watch. Always try to see how you can better use it to its full potential. There's a lot of potential in this, and on this this channel, I actually cover most of the Apple Watch updates and changes that you can do to your Apple Watch to better enhance your experience. So if you haven't subscribed, a sub will be great. Now, before we get all head over heels and too excited for this, there's actually no app yet that can detect COVID-19 for the Apple Watch available. As you can see, these are tests that are being conducted by various private institutions and also universities. And after some time, I'm actually hoping that we don't reach there and COVID-19 will be a thing of the past, just like 2020 is a thing of the past. So hopefully this thing goes behind us and we won't have to worry about it. But in the meantime, as you can see, 2021 isn't so different when it comes to this COVID-19. So this is what technology is doing, and maybe in future, if this thing continues to go on, we might see an app or a feature through a watchOS update or an iOS update when it comes to these health features. So that's about it for me when it comes to this interesting report. It's something that I thought I should share with you. It's very interesting the things that tech has enabled. And with regards to some of the devices that are going to be supported, if this is something that we are going to see rolled out, I'm sure this is something that could come through a watchOS update if you have an Apple Watch. And it won't be exclusively for the Apple Watch, because in some of these studies, they were able to use Fitbit, Garmin, smartwatches, and also the Apple Watch itself to be able to get these readings. So I would like to think that if it's is something that goes, it would have to be like a watch that has ECG and heart rate, so something that supports that should be able to get this if this is something that we are going to see happen. Other than that, that's about it for me. Hope you take care of yourself and stay safe, and I'll see you in the next video very soon. Peace.